Entrepreneurs Board of Investors is challenging America to pitch the next big idea during a 60-second elevator ride.
Time's up.
I've worked so hard for this.
I don't even know if he wants to invest.
What a chicken.
You called me a chicken. Door. You attacked me.
If the pitch fails...
Let's vote. That's four no's. Let's set them down.
Going down.
But if the pitch is successful...
That's three yeses to one no. Let's open the doors.
Welcome to the board.
Yes. Sounds like a deal.
Let's do it.
Yeah.
Is the next billion-dollar idea on its way up? This is Entrepreneur Elevator Pitch.
Going up.
So this show is all about cannabis. We need to hear some green to make some green. Let's hear the first pitch.
Your 60 seconds begins now. Going up.
Hi, my name is Mark Unterbeck. I'm a 59-year-old father of two young men, 21 and 24 years old, and together we started a company called ProCan Labs. Today, I'm here to offer you an investment of $3 million for 5% in convertible debt for an investment into ProCan, which is a licensed California manufacturer of cannabis. We started this journey 2016 and tried to figure out what was the best niche for the market. We worked with the farmers and found out what they needed. They needed to maximize their crop. What we did was we developed a proprietary cold wash ethanol to extract the cannabinoids and the terpenes out of the plant. With that, we take it back, we form a distillate, we sell that out to the farmer or we sell it out to another manufacturer. Last year, our first full year, we did $12 million in revenue with a 46% EBITDA. We took all the money, we plowed it back into the business, and in 2 weeks, we opened up a brand new $8 million state-of-the-art facility.
Five,
your money will go to help us expand into hemp.
Two,
thank you for the opportunity.
I was asleep until I heard the $12 million.
I woke up when he said basically a $60 million valuation, and then all of a sudden I woke up again when he ultimately said $12 million in revenue.
I do see a lot of cannabis-related deals, and his valuation ask is not extreme given their profitability and their revenues.
The part that's tough about this is that the manufacturing side, right now, there's a room for margin. But over time, as it becomes commoditized and there's more and more players, there's more and more licensed businesses that can, you know, pull distillate and go through the extraction process, it becomes less and less appealing. So it's not necessarily an area that we've been too excited about. But his numbers are fantastic for first year of business.
$60 million is one of the biggest asks ever on Elevator Pitch. We got to find out what's going on.
Should we take a vote?
We should take a vote.
Let's do it.
Let's do it.
Looks like it's 2-2. Listen, I get why you guys are skeptical, but who knows that it's going to be $60 million valuation? What if the valuation he's willing to take is $20 million or $10 million? We don't know any facts. So I would ask you to be open-minded and see if there's an opportunity here.
The numbers talk. I mean, green is the new gold. I'm curious to hear more about the marketing and branding and story, backstory behind it. So I'm willing to come on over.
Fantastic. I'm happy you came to see our ways. Let's do it.
Let's go.
It's three yeses to one no. Let's open those doors.
Welcome to the boardroom.
So excited. Thank you so much. Thank you. Very excited to be here.
So you know, this was a 2-2 vote.
I appreciate the angel who gave me a second chance. So.
She will remain nameless.
She's the angel.
Thank you very much.
Can you tell us a little bit about your backstory?
How did I get into cannabis? A good friend of mine is a surgeon up in Oregon, decided he wanted to get into it. I had a look at it for the first time, didn't like what I saw. He stepped away. I started working with some farmers that I had met along the way, realized that there were some similarities between the service people that I used to work with at my .com, not being real business people, farmers not being real business people. And just from conversation, I realized that we would help them monetize their trim, their biomass.
So what's the plan as the market becomes more saturated and more players are moving into kind of the vertically integrated space?
Vertically integrated will not work against us. We have been converting people from vertically integrated. Why? Because we can do it cheaper than they can do it. We've got 7 employees, we did $12 million. We've got 700 square feet, we did $12 million. Our cost to produce a gram of distillate is lower than anybody out there in the market.
So why finance? What do you need the money for? I mean, it sounds like you have a fabulously profitable business.
The key to success in our business, really, we can sell all the oil we can make. Getting the clean biomass on the other side is key. So I try to go out there and develop relationships with the cultivators. One of my largest cultivators down in the Santa Barbara area is now moving into an even larger development of hemp. We have 800,000 square feet of cannabis that we're working with. He's gonna have 6 million square feet of hemp. That's going to give us a tremendous amount of CBD oil. What I'm going to do with this money is use the rest of my building, about 13,000 square feet, and we're going to build that out, and we're going to take all the technology and know-how, the IP that we have with ethanol extraction, and we're going to move it to the other side to hemp.
And you have all the licensing you need from the state and municipality?
We do.
And so what do you think you can do this year just on cannabis?
Just on cannabis, we're projecting 18 to 20.
$60 million valuation is the highest out of every four seasons I've ever been on this. How did you zone into that? Because that is a big ask.
Hemp is going to be global, right? It's going to be imported from overseas. The Canadians think they got it. We'll compete.
Let me just throw something out to the distinguished group and see what your thought is. As a former banker, I think this is really a financing play. We would be prepared to offer you a loan for $3 million. We will get money back on the loan with some agreed upon formula up to $6 million, so 2x our investment. And we'll also have a 2.5% warrant in the company to be able to get upside when you reach a $1 billion valuation.
That's something I'd consider.
Yeah, same here.
If that's something you would agree to, we would be prepared to do that with you.
Let's do it.
Let's do it.
We have a deal.
Let's rock and roll.
Thanks again. Look forward to working with you. Really appreciate the support and confidence. It means so much to me.
Make us a lot of money.
I promise you that.
Okay.
Most exciting thing I've ever done. What I've got here are professionals. I've got people who are experienced, who are diversified, who are going to help us and help me understand how to navigate the treacherous waters. So I've got something nobody else has. We had a great year last year. The future is even brighter.
Your 60 seconds begins now. Going up.
Hi, my name is Ari. I am the creator of Candid. Did you know the wound care industry is one of the fastest growing industries in the entire world? Yeah, me neither. I just had a problem, created a solution. What's the problem? Over 600 million people are allergic to the current triple antibiotic. What's the solution? Well, Candid is. And with over 100% profit margins, we're perfectly poised between purpose and profit. It
That's
features
ridiculous.
An all-organic triple antibiotic with ulmo flower, raw honey, organic tea tree oil, colloidal silver, and organic CBD oil on a latex-free bandage. After 3 weeks of research in Ecuador, my team and I came back and won most beneficial CBD product at the CBD Cup. We were even awarded top 10 military tech by Disruptor Daily. I am seeking a $500K convertible note at a $5 million cap. And $10
Five,
from all of you. Candid. Candid.
One. Well, I love the fact that he put in a whopping 3 weeks of research.
He's very passionate. It's a lot of money he's seeking. But did you guys hear anything about revenues to equate to asking for a valuation of $5 million?
No, and 100% profit margin.
Over 100% profit
margin. Absolutely.
$1 billion.
It can aid.
You know, I think we want sound, serious founders who have something to bring to bear that isn't snake oil, and that's what this felt like to me.
There's still a lot of research being done on CBD and its impacts and how it can be useful in a whole host of manners. I think it would have been better suited if he explained that in a little more detail.
He could have made that very compelling with the right pitch to say, listen, here's why this is better than Neosporin on a Band-Aid, and here's the amazing benefits. I'm getting amazing traction. This is elevator pitch. And at the end of the day, that guy did not deliver the pitch.
Sounds like we're ready to take a vote. What do you guys think?
Let's do it.
Let's do it. Well, looks like that's four no's. I don't want to rip into this too much, but we're sending the Band-Aid guy down.
Going down.
Maybe the bandages didn't rub them. Maybe they don't believe that the wound care industry is the largest in the world growing. Who knows? Everyone out there, you can still help make this a reality.
Okay, let's hear the next pitch.
Your 60 Seconds begins now. Going up.
Hi, my name is Will Carr. I'm a full-time single father and a full-time entrepreneur. Being a dad and working are the two things I love more than anything and the two ways I spend all of my time. I'm the founder of Genesee, and I'm asking for $175,000 for a 5% stake in my company. We use CBD from industrial hemp as an ingredient in all of our products. Our first product was a grass-fed whey protein powder, and in just 6 months, we've gotten into 60 stores. We just left a trade show where we have hundreds of more stores ready to come on board. We're expanding our product line into a plant-based protein powder, but also a protein bar and a 2-ounce wellness shot that retail to the consumer for $3.50, perfect for the impulse buy categories. We have mainstream products. We've just added CBD to them, simple for the consumer to understand. I played basketball in college where I got my engineering degree, and then I went on to play professionally in South America. Let's go. Who wants to try some samples, baby? Woo!
I think he's done, right? Wow. Is he done?
Yeah, I think the energy was a little low for me.
Lacking in passion. Yeah.
So we don't know what sales are, but we know 60 stores. It sounds like...
Hundreds coming tomorrow.
What I like, though, is when you do feel the urgency of someone's on this trajectory and they, you know, feel the heat. So I'd be curious to hear more.
Yeah, I mean, it's just anything that's like powders and bars and stuff. It's a super crowded space, CBD or not.
Right.
This guy was like insane in there. So, I mean, part of me is just intrigued to hear this guy out.
Yeah.
He clearly has a lot of passion. CBD, it's getting to be like a belly button, and everyone has one. There's hundreds of brands coming to market. So for me, it's sort of a challenge looking at that.
Well, let's vote. Why don't we vote?
Yep.
Let's go. Okay, that's 3 yeses. Open the doors.
Welcome to the
Yes, elevator pitch, let's go!
That guy's a maniac.
What is up, guys?
Welcome.
How you doing?
Welcome.
I'm here, I made it.
You made it. So you promised us samples.
I did, you ready for those? So here you go. You guys can pass those. That's a cookies and cream. It's the best tasting protein bar you've ever had, I promise.
Okay, so consumables, it's a crowded space. What is your plan here to compete and be truly differentiated?
Exactly. So I think what really differentiates us is the fact that we have these mainstream products that are already being sold in stores, but we have CBD in them. Everybody that's coming out with CBD brands, they're all oil drops, gummies, boring stuff that nobody really wants. All you gotta do is eat your protein bar. All you gotta do is take your protein shake. All you gotta do is take your 2-ounce wellness shot. Exactly like what the consumer's already doing. They're just getting CBD in their diet now, and they're just getting CBD in that product.
So can you tell us, why are you moving into CBD now, and what do you think the benefits are for your customers?
2 years ago today, I had no idea what CBD was. About 22 months ago, I had turf toe, which is inflammation in your toe. I've been taking ibuprofen for 2 weeks, wasn't helping me. Someone's like, hey, try this. I tried it, 30 minutes later, my toe didn't hurt, and it was CBD. And I was like, why do I not know about this? Like, why have I never heard of this amazing substance? And with my sports background, I immediately thought, why isn't this in sports nutrition products? And so I thought, a protein bar. Millions of protein bars are eaten every day. So why don't we just add some CBD to one in a way that we can still have a price point that's competitive for the marketplace? So our protein bar and our wellness shot retail for $3.50, and we have over 70% gross margins.
What's your revenue?
Year to date, we're at about $60,000 with just our one product. Almost all of that has come since Thanksgiving, so in the last 6 months.
I mean, I so respect and appreciate the hustle, and you know, you bring a level of honesty to the table, which is really great. This $60,000 in sales relative to the valuation here, to me, is just not realistic. So for me, this just doesn't feel like the business makes sense.
Yeah, I have similar challenges too. So again, I think we talk about crowded store shelves, and it's particularly hard for the consumer to even differentiate of all the CBD brands and products.
All I would say is just it's very early, right? And clearly you've identified an interesting way to go after the space, and you know, you have incredible energy. I think we all saw that, and we're really excited about having you out here and really wanted to hear it.
Whatever you have, we want.
Yeah, exactly.
Listen, they did all the heavy lifting for me, so instead of making some speech with generic reasons, not gonna be a go for me either.
So we deeply respect your energy, enthusiasm for your business. It's just going to have to be a pass for us.
Okay. Thanks, guys. I appreciate it.
Thank you. Good luck.
Good luck.
I love being an entrepreneur. I love working around CBD. I love this space. And when I'm not doing this work, I'm being a dad all the time, hands-on, playing with my daughter. No matter what happened in there, like, it didn't matter. I'm here. I'm doing me. I'm doing what I love. So cool. Like, I'll have the right partners.
I think the one lesson here is that he had so much energy and he was able to connect with us in a way that we wanted to hear more.
Yeah.
While he wasn't able to close the deal,
yeah.
Okay, you got to give him credit for at least getting to the opportunity to at least present it.
Yeah, for anyone who's pitching.
100%.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
And now, perfecting the pitch from Sprint Business.
Finally, a pitch that tells us the revenue, the valuation.
So refreshing.
Share your company's successes. Brag about the successes and traction your company has made since its inception. As the CEO of your own company, you'll be expected to be the lead salesperson. So show the investors that you know how to sell them on your company.
This guy's doing real revenue.
Sprint Business works for business. Check out sprint.com/elevator pitch.
Oh my God, I'm so scared. I feel really prepared, but it's like 60 seconds goes by very, very quickly.
Let's hear the next pitch.
Your 60 seconds begins now. Going up.
Is your edible credible? Do you really know what you're purchasing or what to expect from your cannabis and CBD products? You don't, and that's the problem. Hi, I'm Meryl Gilbert, CEO of A True Dose, the very first independent certification program for cannabis and CBD edibles.
Industry definitely needs this.
We're seeking $250,000 to scale the program over the next 12 months. Today, there's over 183 million cannabis users worldwide and thousands of new products coming to market. However, unverified claims and incomplete instructions can lead to unexpected and often horrific consumer experiences. This is unacceptable and it doesn't have to be this way. Leveraging our years of experience and food safety compliance, we created A True Dose. Just like organic and non-GMO certifications, A True Dose goes beyond regulatory requirements to provide credibility and brand recognition. A True Dose, we make your edible credible.
I'd be really curious to hear more from her. The most important thing in my mind is, can she actually scale this as kind of a certification idea around compliance?
Yeah, I mean, I think certification is an interesting idea, but the challenge with most edibles is that it impacts everybody in a very different way.
I think the certification can be, you know, pretty interesting, and we haven't seen anything like this or someone trying to attempt in the space.
So. That says a lot.
Yeah.
You haven't seen
it. Could be interesting.
She didn't do that great of a job of a pitch. All we know is that she's looking for $250,000. We don't know revenue. We don't know her background, which is obviously very key to this whole thing. So she might get lucky with a non-very informative pitch that will let her in, but I think our voting will determine that.
Let's take a vote. Well, this one's easy. It's unanimous. 4-0, so let's bring her in.
Open the doors.
Welcome to the boardroom.
Oh my God,
welcome.
I can't believe you.
Welcome, welcome.
I knew it was coming up. Hi.
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 So this feels like this has three different elements. There's an assessment of some kind, then there's a legal kind of requirement, and then a certification. So can you walk us through what makes you uniquely qualified to be able to deliver
Absolutely.
That?
Absolutely. Thank you. So I have 25 years of experience in the food and beverage industry, and my business partner, her background is also in food manufacturing and compliance. And 4 years ago, we started going down the same path of many people about the future of cannabis and looking at making edibles. And we said we need to really advocate for safe use and really drive a universal conversation around standardization.
So are you more the consumer reports, or are you taking it one step further where you're doing true testing and certification?
Correct. So we don't touch the product, but it's very much in the same business model of a certified organic or a non-GMO project. This is the most important thing and the biggest risk to what is now, you know, last month's claim of $146 billion in global revenue by 2025. The biggest risk is unpredictability.
Are you live with customers and revenue?
So we're in our beta program right now, which includes both manufacturers, retailers, and then our goal is to launch this out to the public to drive awareness.
And what would you use the 250 for?
The 250 is specifically to finish the beta program and to spend on getting this public awareness project off.
So what's the ask? You asked for 250 for what percentage of the company?
We're asking for 250,000 for 5% equity.
for 5%.
I like this a lot. At $250K for 5%, it's a relatively nominal investment. And I think this, the notion of standardization, there's first mover advantage here. I'd be happy to make a bet on this right now.
So I'm gonna push back on that.
Yeah.
Your company is not worth $5 million right now. So I would say it should be 25%. You haven't proven anything yet. This is a lot of money that you're going to need. That's what I think would be a fair valuation to take a leap of faith. And if it works, everybody's happy.
Yeah, I agree. We would not be investing at this stage usually, and certainly not at $5 million. But I do think there is a potential market for this opportunity. So at the 25% level, I would also be comfortable.
Would you be willing to go to 20%? I understand the valuation was high. No, we're on the same team, but I also don't want to strip someone who's going to be a long-term partner. I mean, we're taking 25% of our company at this stage.
I'm good at the 20. I think we did a lot to get there.
I'm intrigued. I think there's a bid ask here of 20, 25. Would you guys consider splitting the difference at 22.5% as a proposal?
I like the idea of that.
22.5%, I'm good to go.
I think 22.5 is fair. I wouldn't get too concerned about the 2.5% if I were you. If you think about the kind of value the team can bring to the table.
So we're only 2.5% apart, and you have one of the top marketing people in the United States, one of the top cannabis funds partners in the United States, one of the most prolific investors in cannabis, and one of the top early stage funds. 2.5%, we're gonna go to war for you.
We have a deal.
All right.
Good job.
They liked it. I think the negotiating was a little harder than I expected, and certainly giving up a little bit more. But we really do see this as a very big opportunity to really be the advocates to lead for safe consumer use and really drive universal standardization ahead of this.
Your 60 seconds begins now. Going up.
Hey everyone, my name is Jeff Wickham, and I'm the co-founder and CEO of Cannally. Cannally is an online wholesale marketplace and sales platform for licensed cannabis brands and retailers. You can think of us as Alibaba for the cannabis industry. We help licensed cannabis retailers consolidate their vendor relationships, meaning they no longer have to order from multiple brands at separate times. They can now order from multiple brands all in one platform, all at one time. We then help the brands accelerate their sales and get their products onto more shelves. Today, we work with over 220 dispensaries and 50 of the top cannabis brands. In 2018, with just a team of three, we did $2.7 million in GMV, and we're on track this year to more than double that. We're here today raising $750,000 for our seed round via a SAFE at a $5 million pre-money valuation.
Five,
I'd love the opportunity
four,
to tell you more
three,
and speak with you today.
Two,
thank you so much
one.
For your time.
Time's up.
That's an interesting marketplace business, you know, playing to all the dispensaries on one side and all the brands on the other.
There is a kind of gorilla in this space already that I'm also an investor in that's doing 200-300 times the GMV they are. Definitely a space I like, given that we're already invested in it. But I think it's going to be hard for others to compete.
Should we take a vote?
Let's take a vote.
So we're two yeses, two noes. We're on the yes side of the house.
I feel like it's a bit of a conflict for me. I know for on my end, it's not super interesting, but...
Peter, you'll need to sway the deal then.
Yeah, I would say marketplace. They see a million of these things, and there's a lot of big players, including one that you're invested in.
Mm-hmm.
There was nothing compelling on how he's going to go toe-to-toe. However, we have learned that sometimes there's a lot more positive than we know of, and if you give people sometimes a chance, you never know what might happen.
Well, that's three yeses, one no, so let's open the doors.
Welcome to the boardroom.
Welcome.
Welcome.
Hi, everyone.
Well, I feel like I should start and let you know that, you know, I have an investment in a company that I think is a more or less a direct competitor to what you're doing.
Awesome. I appreciate you sharing that. I thought you had a familiar face.
But the rest of us don't have an investment, yep. So we'd like to understand what you're doing differently.
We feel that what we're doing, there's enough room for more than one player, and we also feel that what we're doing is differentiated. We've really focused on the sales and marketing aspect in driving new business versus managing existing business.
How are you thinking about future state? Are you going to lean even further into kind of these smaller boutique brands as an Amazon or a Walmart or a Target?
So we see where the market's going with the consolidation. And so we want to be able to serve enterprise brands as well as enterprise retailers. But we also want to be able to enable and help bring small mom and pop brands to market if they have a license.
So maybe talk about how you're able to help these brands get customers, because obviously that's a huge value add.
Yeah, so you know, it's primarily digital marketing. So we have 220 dispensaries. We have all the emails of the buyers for those dispensaries, and we run digital marketing, email marketing, SMS marketing to those dispensaries to then get them to pick up those products.
We are very lucky and fortunate to have one of the experts in the United States of America sitting only inches from us. What is your sort of take on this whole thing? Put the conflict aside.
Well, yeah, I think it's hard to put the conflict aside, unfortunately, and I feel like it's a little bit of a disadvantage to you, given I have, like, a very, very strong bias.
So you have the competitive issue. I have an issue just with where the market is going to meet this 5 years from now.
And for me, my issue is, even though there's a lot of good, make no mistake, I want to see somebody that has made the stake in the ground. I'm a SaaS software company that's a B2B enabler, or I'm a marketplace, and to try to do both, I've seen companies fail doing that.
Yeah, I think you're headed personally in the right direction, but I'd like to see a little bit more proof and evidence and uptake of your larger customers, that you're actually transitioning folks from boutiques and the well-established brands are then continuing to remain with you, and they see value out of your services. I'd like to watch and see what happens over the next year or so with what you guys are doing.
Thank you, though. Great conversation.
Yeah, appreciate it. I will definitely follow up with you guys. Thank you for your time and feedback.
Thank you. Best of luck.
It was a unique experience. You saw, the lead investor from our direct competitor there that maybe threw me off guard a little bit. But overall, it was a positive experience, and I'm glad it happened.
Coming up on the next Entrepreneur Elevator Pitch.
Has anyone ever experienced an edible orgasm?
Oh, my God.
Forget the Miami Vice jacket.
Wow.
And to apply for season 5, go to entrepreneur.com/elevator pitch.
What's up, Elevator Pitch? Will Carr here, founder of Genesee. I am so excited to be bringing you CBD products to market that allow you to get outside, get active, and stay healthy. Since recording of the show, we have started production of our plant-based protein powder, our protein bar, and our 2-ounce wellness shot coming to you Labor Day weekend. Follow us online at Genesee Nutrition. Thank you so much for coming along this journey with us as we revolutionize the health and wellness industry. Let's go!